The GOP race, the big focus, is now on South Carolina. Joining me now, Hugh Hewitt, host of The Hugh Hewitt Show. Happy Monday, sir. Let's play your last prediction Monday night before the New Hampshire primary. So your prediction, you said, is Donald Trump.
Trump, Kasich, Rubio.
All right. So you were pretty close. What do you say about South Carolina?
Well, you know, you can actually say I called Iowa completely right on this one. Rubio got the same number of delegates as Cruz and Bush, so I actually tied for third in delegates. But I was a little bit off. He was hurt more badly
by
the debate than I thought.
But you predicted Kasich, which I thought was very smart.
Yeah. Well, the independents broke for him. But about Rubio, I'll say an old ballad, an old English song, Don, called The Ballad of Sir Andrew Barton, in which it is said the wounded Scots admiral says, I am wounded, I am not slain, I shall lay me down and bleed a while and rise to fight again. I think that was Rubio with Wolf earlier today. I think Ted Cruz has got momentum. Jeb is fighting on. And I look, though, at Donald Trump's crowd in South Carolina tonight, and I say to myself, this is far beyond anything I think he imagined when he began.
So I think we're going to probably play it. So what do you say for South Carolina before we go on to continue to talk about this?
It depends on this debate Saturday night completely. Okay. I was asked tonight on my radio show to make a prediction because I've been pretty close to 100%. And it really depends on Saturday night because the compression of this calendar and the focus on these debates is announced today. Wolf is going to moderate the CNN debate in which I'm participating on February 25th. And that one may be down to three or four, but this one was six with Dr. Carson and the other candidates, is going to allow the candidates a lot more time to talk. And so it will shift the race on its axis again.
Okay.
So no predictions till next week.
Let's talk about this because, you know, as I've been saying, if you tell me you're going to run for president, I'm going to take you seriously. A lot of people didn't take, you know, him seriously, Donald Trump, I'm talking about, and we did. So let's dig into this New Hampshire, these results. Trump wins. His win was convincing. He won across ages, new voters, Republicans, Democrats. Who of the runners-up you think can beat him at this point? Can Trump be stopped?
Oh, yes. Oh, 35%. I don't know if it's a ceiling or a floor. At this point, I don't see Dr. Carson with a path. I see him with a program, and I see him with a role to play, but I don't see him with a path to the nomination. I do see the black swan of American politics coming right at us, the open convention. And anything can happen in something that has been unprecedented. It hasn't happened in my lifetime. And so we don't really know who could come out of that with the nomination. But given what you just said, the big kahuna, Super Tuesday, proportional representation, the delegate count, if I can consult, Trump has 17, Cruz has 11, Rubio 10, Kasich 5, Jeb 4, and Ben Carson 3. It takes 1,237 to win. So we have such a long way to go. Any of these gentlemen can win, and they all have terrific advantages and disadvantages. In South Carolina, you've got Terry Sullivan is Marco Rubio's campaign manager. He knows the state back of his hand, worked for Jim DeMint down there. Jeb Bush has Bush family memory. Both Bush 41 and Bush 43 faced crisis moments in their campaigns. And in 1988, George Herbert Walker Bush was 30 points behind Mike Dukakis. In 2000, W had to go from a blistering loss in New Hampshire to go beat McCain in the pro-military state of South Carolina. But 41 had Lee Atwater, 43 had Rove, and Mike Murphy is walled off from Jeb, so I don't know about that. Ted Cruz, this is really interesting. He's the constitutional expert, and today the Supreme Court put a stay, or yesterday, late last night, the Supreme Court put a stay on President Obama's global climate change throwdown from the EPA. They also, a week earlier, raised the issue of the president not taking care of the laws that he's charged with enforcing. So Ted Cruz's constitutional chops come into play. Everyone's got a strength, and then there's John Kasich.
I've got to ask you this before we get too far afield here. You keep talking about a broker convention that's going to go all the way to the broker convention. Why do you keep saying that? If Donald Trump has enough delegates, or if whoever it has enough delegates, why would the convention then be brokered?
I never say broker, Don. I always say open because there are no brokers. Unlike the Democratic Party, which today managed to find a way to give Hillary 5 delegates out of her blowout, there are no bosses left in the Republican Party. I just do math. It takes 1,237 delegates to be nominated. I don't know how anyone with the rule set that was adopted before anyone knew who was running, Reince Priebus and the Republican National Committee adopted a rule set that leads to a four- or five-way race, which leads to no one getting close to 1,237 delegates. And so it's not brokered. It's just going to be math. And everyone with chips on the table, you know, a committed delegate is going to be invited to the game.
All right, let's talk about Ted Cruz. Well organized in Iowa, and he says that he has the organization to win in South Carolina, especially with evangelicals there. Do you think that he can win there?
I do. I think any of these people could win it. Literally, any one of those five. I don't think Dr. Carson can win. He can have a good showing, but I don't think he can win. Any of the other five could win at this point. And with the evangelicals, Ted Cruz has enormous strength. But I'll point out, I posted over at my website today, Don, an interview I did with John Kasich from 2010 when he put out his book every other Monday about his 20 years in a small group of men of the Christian faith, evangelicals, who have been meeting. His faith and his touch with evangelicals is deep and as authentic as any of them. And so I wouldn't just say, oh, all the evangelicals are going to go with Ted Cruz, though he has a huge head start because of leadership nodding towards him. I find this to be the most interesting 10 days in Republican political history that I can remember. Maybe after Ford and Reagan at the first start, the North Carolina primary in 76, but that's ancient history. This is really intense stuff.
It's been amazing to watch and will be amazing to watch. Thank you, Hugh. I'll see you soon.
Always a pleasure, Don.
Hi, this is Hugh Hewitt. Thank you for stopping by my YouTube channel. Click right here to watch previous ones that you may not have seen, and click right here to subscribe to get all of them. And this is what you really need to do, is click right here to subscribe. Thanks for coming by. Don't miss a minute of any of the Hugh Hewitt YouTubes.